my right, Shalom. It's the brother Rock and the brother Kassab back again from the GMS Atlanta Church with a lesson. All right, but before we get started, we want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, Kodash. Double honors to the elders and apostles at GMS who rule well and peace and safety to the argument across the four corners of the earth that are pushing out the truth and sincerity. All right, now it's, you know, another lesson we got through the spirit and power. Now, Shai, we wanted to go into, all right, about faith, all right, because this thing of ours, all right, is basically faith-based, okay? We got to have faith, all right, in everything that we learn, you know, in everything that we go out and teach, okay? Because, you know, you got niggas trying to, you know, tear down what the Lord has already built up, okay, through all the bullshit that they're trying to come out and say, you know, from, you know, the 12 tribes chart being wrong to, you know, Edomites can be saved, you know, so on and so forth, you know. But, you know, we hear a great millstone, you know, starting with Apostle Tahar on down. Okay, we have the truth, all right? And we say that based on faith, all right? Now, this is Hebrews 11:1. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen, okay? And that word substance basically is what you're made of. It's like the foundation, okay? So our foundation is built upon faith, okay? It says, for evidence of things not seen. Now, we don't have a tangible object, you know, or website that we can go to and say, okay, that's our Lord and Savior there. But, you know, it's all based on faith, okay? And that's why the scriptures say, you know, walk by faith and not by sight, okay? Because, you know, we haven't physically seen, you know, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, but we have faith that he do exist and that everything he say is true.
Khan, hey, that's beautiful. Hey, that's beautifully said, man. That's why, which I'm going to bring out the scripture for you. That's why the scriptures tell you to be persuaded in your own mind, all right? Because, you know, like the brother said, you know, you got all these fools coming out with all these different doctrines and trying to basically throw a wrench in the plan and try to, you know, basically hinder men's faith in what we believe in, right? But because we have faith and we believe that the Spirit is working with our apostles and our elders, that those little distractions, they're not going to take us off of the path that we through the Spirit are following, all right? Because we have faith and we trust in the Lord, man. And ultimately, we have fear of the Lord too, and you know that's why the scriptures also say through fear we persuade men, if you know, roughly paraphrasing. All right, so I got that scripture for you.
Go ahead.
All right, it's Romans 14:5. It says, one man esteemeth one day above another; another esteemeth every day alike. All right, which basically saying that, you know, everybody's walk is not the same, you know, basically.
Yeah.
All right, but it says let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind, basically, which I'm gonna look the word up, you know, for edification purposes, but basically means to convince, all right, or to be mentally changed, if I'm not mistaken. Which it says here, it says, to bear or bring full, to make full, to cause a thing to be shown to be to the full, to fulfill the ministry in every part. It says to fill one with any thought, conviction, all right? To make certain, to persuade, basically to have a trust, and that's what faith is. Like the brother said, substance of things not seen, man, all right? So, you know, and I wasn't going to bring that scripture out, but, you know, based off of the what you just said, I had to bring it out. It says, it goes into the Strong's definition. It says, most surely believe, fully known, all right, to make full proof of, all right? So, you know, that you're not gonna mess up our faith, man. Based off of the things that you demons are trying to do, you're not going to change our minds and what we believe in, all right?
down for me.
Come on, you want me to read it again?
Could you pull a scripture for me? My blue letter's acting up.
Come on, which one you want?
The let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind.
Yeah, I just read it.
Oh, that was you read? Yeah, that was audio. Yeah, reread that.
All right, Con, which one you talk? Okay, Con. Yeah, I just read it. Let me see. It's Romans 14 and 5. One man esteemeth one day above another, another esteemeth every day alike. Let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind.
Yeah, Con, because if you come in this thing and you're not fully persuaded in your own mind, when you run across niggas like that, and niggas in general that have something, you know, totally opposite of what you've been taught, okay, and you're not deeply rooted, okay, things like that can put demons on men, okay, have them thinking, damn. You know, maybe I am going off, or maybe this ain't that, and that ain't this. Yeah. Okay, but that's where faith comes in.
Gone.
All right.
Yeah, having that doubt, you know, doubting the spirit of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? That fuck that, man. We ain't letting that shit happen, man. We gonna continue to push. You know, we gonna disregard the bullshit, and we gonna have faith in what we've been taught because we believe through the spirit that's what it is. Okay.
Yep.
Hey, and you know what having faith is? Is Isaiah 33 and 6, which I bring out for you, because that's what's gonna get us through tough times. Is having that faith in the Lord, man. All right.
That's right.
Isaiah 33 and 6, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, and strength of salvation. Fear of the Lord is his treasure.
Yeah, huh. It should be the stability of thy times, okay? Because when all shit hit the fan and all hell break loose out here, you know, we're not going to have the different channels and avenues that we have right now as far as, you know, seeking the truth or linking up with brothers, you know, and things like that. That's when we're going to have to, you know, rely on that wisdom and knowledge, all right? That's going to be the stability of our times, okay?
Gone.
And nothing else. And that comes along with faith as well. Because let's say you've been laboring, you know, X amount of years, and then when Jacob's trouble come, you know, you fall at the first sign of adversity, then you ain't have faith from the beginning. You're just going through the motions.
You didn't
fully believe. You wasn't fully persuaded in your own mind, you know. And that's going to be the ultimate test, you know. And that's why we say through faith and, you know, Lord willing, we be those men and that he put the spirit on us, you know, when that time comes, that we hold fast, you know, and keep the faith, all right?
That's right. That's right. Hey, and you know what? By not having faith, a lot of these guys is going to take the chip, man. Ultimately, that yep. hour of temptation. They gonna take that chip, man. You know what I'm saying? So we hopefully we be part of the elect, man, and Lord keep that spirit on us and we don't take that mark, man, because I don't want to taste that judgment that comes with taking that chip, man. You know?
That's right.
I got a script for you.
Go ahead.
Come, this is Romans chapter 8, verse 24. It says this is building on or it's adding on to Hebrews 11 and 1 that you just read. It says, for we are saved. It says, for we are saved by hope. But hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why doth he yet hope for? You know?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, kind of. Basically, you know, we are saved by hope. All right. Which, like the brother said, read, you know, it's a substance of things not seen, okay? But we can't see the hope, right? It says, for what man seeth? Why doth he yet hope for? So if we don't see if we saw what we were hoping for, we wouldn't really have faith. But because we can't physically see it, we can spiritually see it, you know, because spiritually we know it's there. That's why we hope for it. All right?
Yeah.
Verse 25 says, but if we hope for that, which I just said, you know, it's going to basically say what I just said. So it says, but if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it? Yeah. Are we going to wait and have faith if we can see what's coming? No. That's why the Lord set it up that way. It's the same thing. Like when the Lord said he's going to come as a thief in the night. If these people knew when exactly the Lord was coming, they would be fucking around until that last second he came. All right?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, not only do we have, you know, the teachings of, you know, the elders and apostles, we also have the scriptures, okay? That give you multiple examples of when men kept the faith, how, you know, the Lord delivered them. All right, so that's why, you know, it's important to read, you know, and study, all right, and get those different accounts, you know, like Daniel and Job. So, you know, and this is Romans chapter 15, verse 4. It says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
There we go.
Okay. And it gives us a sense of, you know, faith and hope, you know, when we read stories, you know, or accounts, if I may say, of men that stayed faithful, you know, to the end and was delivered.
That's right. And that's beautiful because, like you said, Daniel, the faith of Daniel, matter of fact, the faith of his three friends, when they was in that fight, I might have to grab that real quick, man, because that's a beautiful example of faith.
And those three men kept the faith down, you know, to the very last T, you know, to all the way to when they was faced with death, man. You know, they kept the faith, you know. And didn't waver. Hey, they didn't go against and bow down, you know, so to speak. But you can go ahead and grab the account.
This is Daniel chapter 3, verse 17. I'm gonna start at 16. You really? Yeah, I'm gonna start at 16. It says, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter, because basically, they didn't want to bow down to his wicked decree. All right, it says, if it be so, our power whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thine hand, O power. But if not, but see, this is that faith right here. Okay, they was willing to die. They was willing to die for this for Yahweh Shimei Havashai, man. All right, it says, but if not. Basically, if the Lord don't come, we still not going to do it.
That's right.
It says, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his visage was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spake and commanded that they should heat the furnace once 7 times more than was wont to be heated. So basically, he heated up the furnace and he tossed them in the furnace, but they didn't burn because they had that faith, you know, just to cut it short. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yep. That's true. Hey, and that's a beautiful account, Pop. That's probably one of the most, you know, acts of faith that stuck out to me. Okay. Cause the king, he turned the fire up
7 times.
He turned it up double, I believe.
Yeah, 7 times up.
If I'm not mistaken, yes. He did that furnace up even more, you know, and was ready to throw those in. Mm-hmm. Hey, but they stood boldly, Salakia, for the faith.
That's right.
All the way up into that last, you know, that last minute. And that's how it's gonna be with us. When the hour of temptation comes, we're presented with that chip, okay? When we presented with UN martial law and, you know, FEMA camps and things of that nature, okay? That's not the time to be like, well, man, fuck the Lord, you know? All that shit I did, you know, I was wasting time. Nah, man, don't be a nigga like that. Stick to the faith. God. Have faith.
Hey, I got to read verse 25.
Go ahead.
It's Daniel 3:25. This is, you know, after the king threw them in the fire. He said, verse 25 says, he answered and said, lo, I see four men loose walking in the midst of the fire. And they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of the Most High. So, yay, Yahweh Shai, man. We keep our faith. Yahweh Shai going to get us, man. He said, Yahweh Shai going to come get his elect if we are part of that number, man. That's why we got to push and keep that faith.
That's, you know what beautiful. I'm
saying? Yahweh Shai coming, bro.
Yeah, coming. And the same way, hey, when they threw Daniel in the lion, then they went down and checked on him. Hey, man, he was laying upon the beast, man.
He was chilling.
He was just chilling, kicking it.
God. Hey, man.
And that's why that scripture say those things were written for our learning, okay, aforetime, so that we may have faith.
Yep, to boost our faith,
hope,
too.
So to speak. Yeah, come.
Yep, I got a precept for you.
Go ahead.
All right. This is.
And we probably gonna wrap it up after this, huh?
Come. I know you gotta get back to the plantation.
Yeah, come.
All right. This is Well, I'll bring that out another time, but this is real quick. This is the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verse 8. It says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and not, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of the Most High, all right? That gift of faith, man, which we're not to squander, all right? We're not going to squander the gift of the faith of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, man, all right? You know,
reread that.
Come. It says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and not that of yourselves. It is the gift of the Most High.
Yeah. Niggas think they be free-willed, man, that they can, you know, will they self to salvation, man. Nah. And so you got to have faith, man. You ain't going to get it on your own.
Come.
Yeah, but I ain't mean to cut you off.
Nah, that was it, though. That was it. You know, you want to go ahead and close it?
Yeah, kind. You know, Lord willing, that lesson was edifying to an elect brother, too. All right. And before we get out of here again, want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, and Kakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles at GMS, and Shalom to the faithful Akim.
Shalom.